Hi friends, Chandrasekhar here again. I have already given 3 lectures on how to approach a chart, and I hope you have liked it and understood it. Most of my lectures would appear to be very elementary, but remember that unless a foundation is strong enough, no building can withstand it, remain standing for long. Same is with the science. And especially with a complex science like Vedic Astrology. So now, from now onwards, I will try to talk about my understanding about how a bhava lord can give results when occupying another bhava. Now here two very important things have to be understood. That barring sun and moon, every other planet, of course, we will exclude Rahu and Ketu from that. They being Chayagraha, that is shadow planets, who need some energy of some other planet to express themselves. So we are excluding them. But we will talk about it sometime later. We will certainly talk about Rahu and Ketu occupying some bhava. But we initially start with bhava lord in another bhava. I agree that Parashara does give co-ownership of Aquarius to Rahu, and naturally the co-ownership of Ketu to Vrishchika, that is Scorpio. Other grades have different opinion about their Rashi of ownership. Some say Kanya, that is Virgo, is ruled by Rahu, and Meena, that is Pisces, is ruled by Ketu. So we won't go into that. About placement of those two shadow planets, we will talk about them when we perhaps talk about planets placement in bhavas. I am sure you are fine with this. So today I will try to talk about what happens when Lord of Lagna occupies 12 different bhavas. You always must understand, you will have to listen to this carefully. When I talk about all other bhava lords occupying these similar places, and then combine the two to understand what happens in case of, say, Mars, who will be always the owner of one house and six from it or eight from it. The Lagna, or vice versa. When he is lord of one house, the other will be owned, the sixth from it will also be owned by Mars, because he owns two Rashis, Aries and Scorpio, is it? So keep that at the back of your mind. Otherwise you might sometimes find this does not apply verbatim, but if you go through the entire series of lectures, you will find more or less this is how the planets express themselves. So now we talk about Lagna Lord. The most important is the Lord of the Lagna. When he occupies the Lagna, he denotes confidence, one. Fairly good body is the another aspect of the Lagna Lord. And he might, if he is too strong, might also indicate confidence verging on ego. Now this same Lagna, because he expresses himself through his own bhava, the Tanu bhava, the body will be pretty strong. Generally it would be a healthy body. Unless, of course, as I was saying earlier, he is also supposed to be the lord of the sixth or eighth or something like that, simultaneously. But let us not get into that. We will go to the next bhava, which is the second bhava, which is the Dhana bhava. The house of wealth, as they call, or kutumba, family, or speech, or ornaments, and honor. That is the garments of honor, they call it actually, not honor as such. That honor is restricted to the 10th house, honor by a public. But the garments of honor, which are sometimes given when you are honored, then they are represented by the second house. Vastra Alankar is the word used. So when he is in the sacred house, what happens? As a Lagna Lord, he indicates that this Jataka will have accumulated wealth earned by himself through his own efforts. Because he is sitting in the sacred house, he takes shelter of that house and expresses himself. He would be attached to his family also, because that is the house of family. If he gets recognition or some honor, it would also be through his own efforts. Dhana will be there, money will be there, but it would be more in the form of assets. He creates his own assets. He might get some from his father, which we will come to at a later stage. Then the Lagna Lord goes to the third house. Third house is house of valor. So he will be valorous. He will be able to deliver results. And he might also sometimes be helpful to his brother, because third house is house of brother, or his brother might be part of his gaining recognition for his valor or his efficiency at work and so on. Sometimes, mind well, it also can cause some problem with the brothers or sisters, whatever, because third house is, we call it Bhratru Bhava, meaning house of brothers, but in Sanskrit when we talk of brothers, it also includes sisters. Like in the fifth bhava, where we call Putra Bhava, that is bhava for son, it also includes daughter. Why? Because he would want to express himself through his brother. So he might be so ambitious and he might want his brother to be as valorous as him, and that could cause some friction between brothers. This would be more so if it is a malefic planet. Or the brother and this Jataka might be living at different places, which then reduces the friction. Rather, it can even create much affinity between the two. Then the Lagna Bhava occupies the fourth house. Now there's this house of happiness. He expresses himself through happiness. So he will be happy. He would have his own house, because that is house, a lord of house. So he would create his own house. He would buy his own house. Not he might have ancestral house because of the sacred bhava and different influences on it, but he could perhaps buy his own house out of his own funds, his own vehicle. There could be some problem with mother, or he might want to influence the mother. He wants mother to behave like himself. Now, it is not always that when you like somebody to behave like yourself, that person is happy. So there could be some small problems, but not big problems at all. So, because fourth house ultimately is his place of happiness. He will be happy remaining at home or in his own birthplace or country of birth. He would be pretty fine there. Then we come to the fifth house. Now here we have to understand that he will gain advanced knowledge through his own efforts, because that is the house of advanced knowledge. That is also the house of acquired knowledge, which means any knowledge which is beyond whatever you need minimum in the country or place of birth or where you are residing to get a good career. So he would learn much from experiences, which is very good, but there is a downside to it. He would try to express himself through his first progeny, and that is why even Parashara has said that the Jataka might lose his first child. I would say it would depend whether he loses child or he has some small tiff with the firstborn, because see, if it is a benefic planet by nature, the problem would be lesser. If it is a malefic planet, yes, there could be problem. And he might have a bit of misunderstanding with his progeny, because he wants them to grow exactly like him. So he might even try to impose his will on their career, which might create some friction between the two. Now, coming to the sixth house, he would express himself through his relatives. So he would be comfortable with relatives, but the problem is many a time these people have some problem with relatives. One, classic stock of his having diseases, which is possible because it is also house of disease, the sixth house. But if you ask me my interpretation, that person would be his own enemy. which means most of his problems or you know, negative issues that arise in his life will be because of his own doing. He acts as his own enemy because Lagna Lord, representing the Jataka, is occupying the sixth house. So he will take benefit of that negativism, that enmity with himself. So, and you can test it on the charts that you get, especially those walking type of charts where you don't know anything about the Jataka. He would of course be good at work. He might be good at serving others, which we can call job. And then we go to the seventh house. So Lagna Lord sitting in the seventh house would want to impose his will would want his spouse to behave like him, which could cause some friction, but on the other side they might merge. So you might sometimes find very great understanding between spouse and the Jataka, especially if it is a benefic planet, the Lagna Lord. Malefic planet can indicate many things, which we will talk when we talk about planet in a house, if you so desire at a later stage. Let me know whether you want that. And so then Lagna Lord going through the earth, the common what can I call it, the common results of Lagna Lord in the earth is given as health issues. I have a different opinion about it. You can test it. As I said, I think earth house being the Ayush Bhava, that person will have long life, because Lagna Lord expressing himself through house of life would tend to give longer life to the Jataka. I am not talking about the aspects at the moment, because that is absolutely a different ball game. I think in the last lecture you have also heard that if Jupiter aspects a house, it will strengthen the house and so on and so forth. But we are talking about placement of a Lord of a Bhava in another Bhava expressing himself. Now Lord of the Lagna in the ninth house. Here also you will find some, either the Jataka will try to behave as his father does, and which would not generally cause problem, because fathers also always want the son to follow his own example or complete his own unfinished dreams. So perhaps they would have fairly good relations, and he would be the creator of his own fortune. So when we say somebody has, he has a great fortune, he got this opportunity, in such sort of cases that person himself would be the initiator of that opportunity at some level or other. So it is not as if others would come and help him, he would create that opportunity himself. Now we go to the next bhava, which is the 10th bhava. Lagna Lord in the 10th bhava, that is bhava of honor, recognition. So this guy will get recognition through his own efforts. Please remember this. You will find the corollary to it when we talk about the 10th Lord occupying sub bhava. This is very important. Lagna Lord in the 10th house will indicate whatever fame he gets will be through his own efforts. Of course, if it is a malefic, he can also have some problem with the reputation, but yet he would have good reputation. I mean, if he is a criminal, he may have a reputation as a great criminal. That is a different issue that we will come to when we talk about nature of planets occupying the bhava or individual planets occupying particular bhava. But the Jataka's own efforts will gain him recognition. That part is almost certain. When it will happen? During the proper dasha. That one always has to understand when we talk about what happens when a particular lord occupies particular bhava, or particular planets is placed in particular bhava, or particular transit is there. All these things have to converge. I think we have talked about it earlier also. Now, Lord of the Lagna occupying the 11th bhava would mean he earns through dint of his own strength. He would earn on his own. He may be son of a or daughter of a multimillionaire, and yet he would earn on his own. It is not necessary he would follow his father's profession or his family profession, and just because he happens to come there and earns. No, this is a different ballgame. See. So he earns by the dint of his own strengths, his own abilities. The downside is with elder sibling, he might have some problems. If, of course, if it is a benefic, it will be smart if, which will then disappear when the transits and the shas change. If it is a malefic, the problem could be a bit more. But yet, this person will earn through his own efforts. That is certain. Now, the last of the bhava, the 12th bhava. This is a placement which is a bit peculiar, you see. In the 12th, it is generally given out by the classic test that he will have problems to his body, that is to his health, naturally, because if the lord of the body, lord representing the body, goes to the house of expenditure, what happens is the body gets spent, which means he has problems with body. So you can say diseases, some ailments. But remember another thing, this person might succeed if he goes to distant lands, because 12th is also the bhava for distant lands, a place which is distinctly different in culture than in the one in which this jataka was born. So don't get scared when somebody says it's bad for health. No, it could also mean that this jataka better go to a different land, and that would give him prosperity. Otherwise, he might have health problems. He might even make losses because of his own heavy expenditure or tendency of spending too much. Because Lagna Lord, sitting in the house of Vyaya, that is the house of expenditure, will spend. In which way? Depending on the planet and its nature, he will spend in that manner. So if it is Saturn, say he will spend perhaps in speculations or boozing or even stock market speculations and so on and so forth, would not have sound sleep. Or he might shift to a distant land and earn very well from it. So this we always have to understand. Please understand, this is my interpretation of how the bhava lords express themselves from different bhava. At some places you might find it is different from classics. For example, classics say that if Lagna Lord is sitting in the 7th house, he might have a problem with spouse. I would not think so. I think he merges with the spouse, so they have much better understanding. This is assuming no other planets are aspecting it or conjoining it, and the bhava doesn't have any other negative bhava ownership. So, but this is how, when you start looking at a chart, start from this point. Look at the positive aspect of it. Talk about it first. If it is something is negative, confirm it at two or three places. So you have got many tools. You have got the transits. You have got the bhava position. You have got the nature of the planets, and then you have got the karakas and their strengths and weaknesses, and individual nature of the rashis, which we have already all of which we have seen about. And after understanding this, then go to the next day. I will now close this lecture. We have completed the 12 bhava, and if you have any more suggestions about how should I present this, as you know, I talk extempore, so it's very difficult for me to give a lecture in a standard format. That's not my way of doing things, but anyway, give your suggestions, they are always welcome. And the next lecture will be on the Lord of the Second, Dvitiya Bhava Adhipati, as they call it in Sanskrit, in different bhavas. And we will see how he may manifest. You have to understand, you understand a principle, try to apply it. How I apply it, I am telling you. If you like it, it's great. Learn from it. If there is something wrong, find out what is where we are making a mistake. Because many a times we forget the nature of a planet, we forget the aspects of the planet. Also the aspects that the planet about which we are talking is having on other bhavas, because on that bhava also he will have some aspect. Like, see, Lagna Bhava in the 12th house, Lagna Lord will be aspecting the 6th house, so he could cause some diseases related to the 6th house. That part we will talk about when we talk about maybe diseases at some point of time. It's a tedious and complex subject. You need a lot of logic to come to the final conclusion, but if all of you like and if I have the time and the inclination, I'll certainly talk about it at some very late date, because that needs much more understanding of astrology and human anatomy and physiology for us to go ahead. But I try to do that also. So my friends, thank you. You have been giving me patient hearing. Many of you have subscribed to the channel. I mean, if you like the lectures, you can even ask other students of astrology to subscribe to the channel. This is a non-profit channel, so you don't worry if you can't ask anybody to subscribe to the channel. If you like it, you can do that. My idea is to give to the society whatever I have learned in all these years of my life. And so I'll say good night to you and thank you once again. Thank you very much.